What I want to do here is show you some of the boards that I built with my SMD toaster oven. And this is one of my boards that's called the Skinny Latte. I have some other videos on it, but just to go over it, here's a 5 volt regulator, and this is a reverse protection diode here, electrolytic capacitor. Okay, I have 3 switches right here. These are SMD tactile switches, and I have them connected here to a PIC chip, a 16F628A, and these are run into the RB4, RB5, and RB6 inputs into the chip, so that those particular inputs have interrupt on change, which helps in programming when you want to interrupt a routine when the switch is actuated. Switches are held high with a 10K resistor here. Now this is a network resistor, and I run 5 volts into it here and to each one of the switches and to the inputs. And if I want to sense an interrupt, when I press the switch, it runs it to ground, and the current then goes from the regulator through the resistor to ground, pulling the chip down to zero, the chip input. That's how I run that input. Down here, this is the reset, master reset switch on a chip if I want to run a master reset. Over here I have a LED. This just runs straight off the 5 volts power through a resistor, and that's kind of an optional if you want to have it on the board to know that the power is on the board. Over here I have outputs. These are all outputs, and they're running over here to a surface mount LED. There's 8 LEDs. So the power comes out of the pin, goes to the LED, and then goes to a resistor, and then to ground. And again, this is a networked resistor. That just helps me when I'm constructing it. It's less components to have to deal with. And if I want to take the outputs off board, what I can do is I can put a pin header right in here. And if I remove this jumper right here, if I remove that pin jumper, then this side of the resistor comes over to this pin, and this pin is ground, the center pin. If I remove that, then there's an open circuit between the resistor and the ground, so that the output, your output, can be taken off board. So I can put this jumper in here and do my programming and testing, and then move the jumper over and have the output go off board and drive circuits. Now, same thing here, up here with the switches. I can take the switches off board. These switches are run high, as I explained before, off the resistor. And to actuate them, when you press them, the high output goes to ground. So I can run these off board. This is a ground here, and this is the different switches, 1, 2, and 3. And the center one there is ground, so I can run that off board and ground out the high state, so I can sense that on the PIC chip. This is, of course, a crystal oscillator with 222 picofarad capacitors and a programming pin header right here. And those are the components that are on this this surface mount board. Now, the nice thing about this is, look at that. It has 1, 2, 3, 4, only four vias, and the pin headers. So I can set this in the oven with the components on it, lay the components on it, set it in the oven, and everything's done. It's all soldered together. It's all ready to go.